This is chapter number one, tracing changes through 1,000 years. So we are talking about 700 to 752, that is around 1,000 years. Now we discussed about two handwritings, the Nastaliq, which you see on the left hand side, the Shikast on the right hand side. Nastaliq is quite easy. The right hand side Shikast is denser and difficult to learn and understand. So these kind of manuscript or the lipic scribes, Nakal Navis, they were copying things. So there is a variety of difference in the writing. Now, new social and political groups, we are talking about 700 to 1750, this range, common era. So here various technologies, discoveries came into action, came into being. For example, Persian wheel. This is a Persian wheel. Means the water comes out through Persian wheel and this water is then sent for irrigation. So it's a kind of a very conventional but very effective way of irrigation. Along with this, we have spinning wheel in weaving. You might relate it with Mahatma Gandhi, that is how to make thread from the raw material. So this is the spinning wheel in weaving. Then in combat fighting, the use of firearm, those which have barood, that is that can create fire. Then along with this, food and beverage like this corn, bhutta, we have alu, potatoes, mirchi, chilies, then tea and coffee, chai. So all these were being used. People were drinking it, using it. So when people go from one place to another, they just do, not only people go, their ideas go, their thought goes. So economical, political, social, cultural, there are certain changes which happen when people move from one place to another. Because there was mobility, and mobility, as I said, that the air and people, they're always moving. Palayan. So they were not going one and two, they are going in groups. So whenever people go, they take their ideas, their thoughts, etc. Now in this time there was one caste, Rajputs. These people became very prominent, important, respected. Rajput means, Raj means rule, Shasak. And Put means son, Putra, son. Rajput, that is ruler's son. So between 8th and 14th centuries, this term was given or applied or used for the warriors. If you see Bamman, Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, these belong to Kshatriya, or they were saying that they claim that we are Kshatriyas, we have this caste status. Warrior means what? Means to fight for your region, to fight for your land. This is the work of Kshatriyas. So not only the rulers, but the Samants, that is chieftains. Samant, chieftains, even the commanders, soldiers, everyone who was fighting for their homeland or country or the region, they all were Kshatriyas. And these Kshatriyas were praised by various poets because they used to, kill themselves or kill others. Means they just fight. And they were so powerful at that time. So poets, they actually wrote about them. And at this time, if you remember, we have Marathas, Sikhs, Jat. In our Indian army, we have Maratha regiment, Sikh regiment, Jat regiment. Because they were so powerful, they were fighters. Along with this, Ahoms, and Kayasthas. These Kayasthas were basically scribes, means who are doing the writing work, and also the Munshis, secretaries. Kayastha, like we have Shivastavs right now, Porwals, like this. So we have Kayasthas, and they were doing the work of either writing work or munshi, secretaries, or looking after the amount, billing, taxes. So they also, these all people also became politically important. Now at this time, what happened? This is a forest. So the various part of the forest were cleared. They were cleared in order to open the land for agriculture, to extend the agriculture. Now here, the people were, who lives, you know, the people used to live here, it was their habitat. That is, this is the environment or the region where they live. They have certain social and economic lifestyle. So the resident of certain area, which is peculiar to them, peculiar to their community, is the habitat. So these people who are actually having the habitat as forest, they were forced to leave this land because actually the forest land was cleared. So these people, what do they do? They would come to some other place like the villages, and they started doing small work like farming, like becoming agriculturist, or becoming, because they were landless now, so they were working in farmers' land, big farmers' land. So they were laborers, agricultural laborers, but landless agricultural laborers. So these are, you know, BF is for the those farmers which are below that level or don't have any land. So these farmers which are having land and those which are not having land, there was a great difference of money. One became richer and richer, one became poorer and poorer. Okay. So there was a society, and these peasants, these farmers, landless farmers, they came in contact with various other communities like the going to market, chieftains, priests, monasteries, temples. So they also came in contact with the other people who are living in the village or the city. Right? So this is how these people who changed their habitat, became landless farmers, and now they are poor and they have a lot of contacts. Okay. Now this difference actually increased. So let me tell you one area. There are different areas. So in one area, there were a jati. Jati means people who are following the same culture, religion, or trade. So there were rules and regulations how to live in this community. Like, you will not do this thing, you will not kill, not do any burglary, or marry in the same community, marry your sisters, like this. So these jatis, the rules and regulations were enforced by the elderly people, big people, those who are respected in the community. So these are the big people. This jati rules and regulations are being enforced, which are being made for the all the people there. This jati is, this sabha is called as jati panchayat. This sabha, this committee, this meeting is called as jati panchayat of the elderly people, who would enforce the rules and regulation which has to be done by everyone in the community. Jati panchayat. Okay? Jati panchayat. Like we have today khap panchayat or panch in the panchayat. So these all happened earlier also. Sometimes if you do wrong work, you will be, you know, kept out of the community. Now in this time, we will be talking about all these in quite detail. Cholas, Tughlaqs, Mughals, all these we will be talking about in great detail, because they had a very big empire. I'll give an example. There is a Sanskrit prashasti, and in this prashasti, it is in praise of, it is being clearly written that the Delhi Sultan Ghiyasuddin Balban, please remember this name, this is being asked number of times. Delhi Sultan, in this prashasti, clearly written that Ghiyasuddin Balban, he had a vast empire. It starts from Bengal, which is God, from Bengal to all over Afghanistan, that is Gajan or Ghazni. So Bengal to Afghanistan, he had a long, big empire. And this also goes up to South India. Bengal to Afghanistan, Gajan or Ghazni. Along with his empire, Ghiyasuddin Balban, goes up to Dravid or South India. So this we know by the prashastis, and we will be talking about them in quite detail, like Cholas, Mughals, etc. And here one more thing happened. You know, when we talk about 700 to 1750, all things almost settled down, because the areas, regions were quite clear, somewhat clear, and what is the bhasha, what is the language being spoken, what is the culture of that particular area people. So the characteristic, the geographical area, the talk, the culture, it was almost settled down. So there was a concrete, differences you can say. So the Cholas, Khiljis, Tughlaqs, Mughals, they made big empire. Pan-regional, pan means all over India. They made a big empire. But the problem was they were not stable. Their empire, they made it, but what was not successful to keep them intact. So when this disintegrated, it disintegrated into different diverse small regions, right? Different small region. So these small region, emergence of regional states. For example, in India, we have 28 states. If you compare it with the empire of, say, Mughals, it may have certain parts which disintegrated, and these were the advent of regional states. Now, religion is very important. At this time, religion, various religion or changes in the religion happened. Major development of religion in terms of tradition happened. Because in Hindu dharma, in Hinduism, in Sanatan dharma, what happened? There was previously only few deities, few gods and goddesses. Deities is a combined or collective word for all the god and goddesses, because Hindus have in crores Bhagwan and Matai. So deities is a common word, combined word. So the way they were worshipped changed. The temples, new deities, new Bhagwan were being worshipped. And Brahmans, the priests, the people who belong to the higher caste, they were the dominant groups. They were the stronger group. They were the most respected group. Why? Because they knew Sanskrit. They knew Sanskrit. That is why Brahmins were respected in the society at this era. And big rulers also, they would, because it involves religion. And when religion involves, everyone gets emotional. So the rulers also, they were taking care of protecting the Brahmins. So one more thing came, bhakti. Like if you take me, now I want to praise Lord Shiva. I don't need any Brahman or Purohit or Panditji between me. So what happened is this time that I can directly go to, I can have a pratima of Lord Shiva and I can do the worship, and with clear heart, I know that he is going to help me, he is going to comfort me, right? Now in this time, there was a new religion. Huzur Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Huzur Muhammad Sahib, he introduced a new religion, and that religion is Islam. That religion is Islam, and it spread by merchants and migrants. We have 1.7 billion people who are Muslims all over the world. So after Christianity is 2.3 billion. So after Christianity, Muslim or Islam is the second largest dharm or religion. So why this became so popular? You know, the religious kitab or book of Islam is Quran. Just like Christians have Bible, just like Hindus have Bhagavad Gita and Puran, same way Quran is for Muslims. You know, why people went to this religion? Because in this religion, everyone is equal. There are five pillars. You have to be equal to one another. You have to love everyone. No burglary, no drink, no pork, no alcohol. And there are five pillars. Five pillars. One is to help poor. This is one pillar. Second, poor is to do prayers five times a day. Then you have to go to the Hajj. This is the third pillar. So there are certain pillars, and Ramzan you have to be fasting. So all these have no problem with anyone, no fight, no problem, quarrel. So it was so clean and best religion at that time. People actually started wanting to be a Muslim. So at that time, when Muhammad Sahab, Huzur, when he died, he was the messenger of the God. When he died, his brother-in-law, Hazrat Ali. Now Shia faction says that Ali, Hazrat Ali is our leader. But Sunni people said, that faction of Islam or Muslim said, that whoever is layak, whoever has the capability, he can be a leader. It's not that only the person who is the relative of Hazrat Muhammad is going to be a leader. So these five pillars, as I said, they both worship Allah. They both have Islam, holy book, the Quran, and they have five pillars, Shia Sunni. If you come to India, we have more factions. This happens everywhere, you know. Hanafi and Shafi, all these different factions, different thoughts have developed. And that is the problem with every religion. Even Christians have Catholic, Protestant. So we are talking about the era. Whenever we talk about an era or a book, just see a book. We divide it into chapters. Because you cannot read a book like a novel. You have to have a different chapters. Similarly, if you want to learn history, we ought to have different parts, different eras. So Britishers came and they said, okay, we will divide this era into three parts. Hindu part, Muslim part, and British part. So very few division people actually wanted this, or they went with this kind of division. Because actually the diversity of this subcontinent is not carried away, because these are quite interlinked. We don't have any clear distinction. So actual diversity of our subcontinent was ignored in this kind of division, Hindu, Muslim and British. So few historians believe this. Few historians. Right? Because, you know, things change. If you take God classification, things should be static for some time. It should not change. It has to be, these factions or these categories should be having a clear picture. So we are talking about 700 to 1750. Now we call this as a medieval age. Madhyakalin Yuga. Medieval age. Right? And here we have the different changes like spread of peasant societies, imperial state formation. We have Hinduism, Islam, this as a major religion, arrival of European trading companies. So medieval and modern have difference. Medieval means Madhyakal. Modern means at this time new discoveries, technical invention have taken place, modernization taken place. Medieval is not modern. Okay, they look same, but it's quite different. So there has to be a concrete difference between them. Modern means modernity. So one thing I just mentioned to you, European trading companies. Why? Because at that time India was rich. Sone ki chidiya. We were sone ki chidiya. So this attracted various foreigners like the European trading companies to come and trade here. Come and take those stuff which are popular here, like the black pepper, like the kapas, cotton, like the spices. So these are those many things which are to be offered. Okay. So this is all about this chapter. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.